This program is brought to you by UCKG.
On today's Love Talk, we're going on a trip for two. Expect more from our celebrity couples, street interviews, and of course our sofa talk as we discuss today's topic with our guests in the studio. The question we're asking today is, why are people getting married later on in life and having sex sooner? Marriage was once strongly considered a rite of passage, and though for some that hasn't changed, for many it's now considered an unnecessary act that is likely to end in divorce. The same with sex. Before, it was considered as something that should only happen after marriage, but now it's become a race amongst teenagers to see who can lose their virginity first. According to the website marriageabout.com, today more and more couples are waiting until their 30s to get married. They often don't marry due to economic reasons, they marry someone they love as opposed to someone who can give them advantage, they postpone having children, and they limit the number of children they do have. If the marriage doesn't work out, they have no guilt in getting a divorce. Is this really the way that society is going? Let's find out on today's show.
Hello everyone and welcome to Love Talk. Today on the show we are looking into the correlation between getting married later and having sex sooner in life.
Why does it seem that people are now choosing to get married when they are much older, but hold no reservations to having sex sooner?
A project done in America called the Tie the Knot Project found that unmarried 20-somethings are more likely to drink excessively and suffer from depression than their married counterparts.
But I can imagine this isn't obvious to those who are living a young life, whether this is, you know, married or unmarried, unless they first gather the statistics.
As this is something that has become somewhat a current discussion, we have taken this topic to the streets of London to see what you have to say on it.
Do you think less people are getting married young now than before?
Yes, I do think less people are getting married young, but I think quite a lot of people aren't getting married at all as well.
I think the aspirations of the young people today have changed slightly. I mean, obviously we've got universities and stuff like this. More and more young people are going to universities and this kind of thing. And I think that that is more of an aspiration for young people, is to maybe pursue in their career and stuff like this.
I think definitely women are putting off getting married, so they're getting married later, maybe in their 30s, when they would have been getting married in their late teens and their 20s in the past. Just because we want to have it all, we want to have the job, we want to have the career. Marriage probably isn't our top priority, as it used to be.
Is marriage still something people aspire to have, do you think?
I don't think it really matters now as much, because I think people are more accepting when you're not married, like whether you want to have kids before. Like in the past, you used to be married to have kids before, so I don't think it doesn't really matter that much.
I don't think it's as much of a need as it ever has been before, so it's like, it's kind of take it or leave it.
I think it depends on the person, and I think marriage, the meaning of marriage has changed. It's not just man and woman anymore.
Do you think there's a rush among young people to have sex today?
Definitely. There's quite a lot of pressure, especially as a teenager going out for school. It's quite like, oh, you need to lose your virginity at this age. So it's quite a big pressure thing, actually. And like, you get bullied if you're not while you're like 16. It's pathetic.
I do think there is still a status attached to it, but I never felt that pressure, so I guess I was quite lucky.
Do you think being sexually active at a young age is a reason people might postpone getting married later?
I think now, not for everyone, but for quite a lot of young people, just to be able to have the access to sex with lots of people, it's a lot more common rather than just being a bit more picky about who you go out with. So I don't know, really, I don't think it really matters that much for young people now. So
I think in the past, having sex was probably one of the motivations for getting married, especially when you weren't allowed premarital sex. So people would have quite short engagements and get married quite quickly, obviously, because they wanted to go further in their relationship. But these days you can pretty much have sex whenever you want. So it's not like you get married because of sex. So I think I think that's a good thing. I think women are much more free these days to be sexually liberated and not be pressured into marriage, and I think that's positive.
What do you think the fears of marriage are for young people?
I think they fear the most about divorce, I guess, or like adultery. Lots of it's more common now, or it's more public because of social media to find out and stuff like that.
I think being tied down to one person and not having that kind of lifelong commitment is quite scary, I guess.
Forever's a long time. That'd be one of my fears. And also, you hear so many horror stories. I don't know what the statistic is, but at one point it was 1 in 3 don't last, which is pretty horrible.
I think money, and falling out. I think monogamy is quite a big thing, quite a big commitment, so lots of people are scared of that. So they'll put off getting married because it's very constricting and you feel a lot less free.
That was a very nice varied opinion from everyone, I think.
It's quite interesting because this topic draws a very fine line with cohabitation versus marriage. It seems a lot of people are opting out of marriage not because they don't want to be with someone, but rather because they fail to see the need if they are cohabitating.
The Atlantic magazine online cited that a fear of divorce was one of the main reasons young people opt out of marriage today.
People choosing to get married later could be, in some cases, for a very good reason, such as finishing college or working overseas, according to thoughtcatalog.com.
However, what is for some a valid fear or reason can be for others an excuse.
Exactly. The same website also mentions some of the less valid reasons, such as taking time to find oneself, whatever this means. Find yourself. If you know what you want, you know what you want, right?
Exactly. It's funny. Imagine someone turning down a marriage proposal because they need time to find themselves.
In some cases, people use cohabitation as a reason to test drive the relationship before they get married, but they risk a danger of never getting married if their circumstance becomes too comfortable.
Let's have a look at this video to see what more we can learn from this topic.
Today, more and more men are choosing not to go to school, not to get a job, and not to get married. If similar numbers of women were doing the same, someone would raise the alarm. But since men are the ones opting out, the problem has been mostly met with silence. Some books say that men are just a bunch of lazy, stoner frat boys who are acting immaturely. In reality, men are acting rationally and opting out of education, work, and marriage because in all of these areas, the penalties are high and the rewards are low. Each of these areas has its own problems and is important in its own right. But for now, we'll just look at why men are avoiding marriage and fatherhood. The first reason that men don't want to get married is that they'll lose respect. In the past, a man wasn't considered a true adult until he was married and had children. Today, however, husbands and fathers are the butts of jokes, and the media constantly portrays them as buffoons and bumbling idiots. The second reason is that they'll lose out on sex. Men who cohabitate with their partner, but aren't married, have much more sex than their wedded counterparts. Recent studies have also found that cohabitators are happier and more confident than married couples. The third reason that men don't want to get married is that they could lose their children and their money. Men are aware of the dangers of divorce, specifically that the courts tend to favor mothers. Men only get custody of their children 10% of the time, and overwhelmingly are responsible for paying child support and alimony. The fourth reason is that men will lose their space. Once a man gets married, he's relegated to the dirtiest part of the house, the attic, the basement, the garage. The entire house is supposed to be a shared space, but the rise of the man cave means that the home is increasingly becoming the domain of only the wife and children. The fifth reason that men don't want to get married is that they can lose their freedom. If a man gets divorced and can't afford child support, he can get locked up. On any given day, there are almost 50,000 people in jail due to child support arrears, most of them male. For example, in Massachusetts, 96% of the people incarcerated for unpaid child support are men. The final reason that men don't want to get married is that the single life is better than ever. In the past, single men were looked at with suspicion, but this is no longer the case. There are plenty of 40-year-old bachelors. Employers look favorably at employees with non-conflicting family responsibilities. Dating has gotten easier, and premarital sex is no longer taboo. On top of this, there's more to entertain single men today than there was in the past, with video games, cable TV, and the internet providing diversions not previously available. To recap, men are opting out of marriage, in addition to education and work, at alarming rates. This isn't due to laziness, but due to rational choices where men no longer see the value of participating in these areas. People respond to incentives, so if we want more men to marry, it needs to be a more attractive proposition.
It's more a case now than ever that fewer young people are getting married, and that video stated some very good points as to why that might be.
There is, of course, the biggest reason that many young people give, and that is losing freedom.
There's an old saying that goes, live while you're young, which can be interpreted as live recklessly, which quite often involves taking on as little responsibility as possible and could very well be a reason why marriage is not on many people's cards nowadays.
Well, let's go for a short break, but don't go anywhere.
This program is brought to you by UCKG. This program is brought to you by UCKG.
Welcome back. Today we're talking about the bridge between getting married later and having sex sooner. Now, if you've been affected by anything on the show today and you'd like to talk to someone, then give us a call on 020-7686-6300. You can also send us an email to questions@lovetalkshow.tv, or you can visit our Twitter or Facebook account.
Absolutely. So we've already touched base on why some young people choose to marry later, but why do some rush into sex sooner?
This question even ties into a point we made earlier about cohabitation being a reason for some people to test a relationship. But sex can to some also be viewed in the same way. What was once considered a sacred thing for committed couples can now come across as an invitation to a relationship.
This is such a broad part of the topic that I think it even deserves its own show dedicated to it.
Let's try and keep it within the context as we speak to our guests about this topic today. We have on the show today two people who know the price that comes with getting married at a time in their lives when many people their age would be thinking of other things. Let's meet our guests today.
Hello and welcome to this week's quiz. Today I have with me Adama and Sylvester. Hello.
Hello.
Hi. Well, they have just been married, you know, they just got married like a month ago, but we still want to know how well they know each other. So the rules are very simple. Adama and Sylvester, pay close attention. You only have 10 seconds to answer each question correctly. You've got only 5 questions each. Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
So, are you really? Okay, so we're going to start with Adama today. Adama, first question.
Yes.
What annoys Sylvester the most? 10 seconds.
Probably when I...
10 seconds.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah, no more time. Sorry.
Oh, no.
Question number two, you still have 4 to go, okay. So don't give up, okay?
I won't.
What are you two most likely to argue about? 10 seconds.
Something really silly. I have to think, what could be specific? Oh, what to eat for dinner, where to go out to eat.
Exactly.
A movie to watch. Really silly things we argue about.
Correctly, you just nailed it. Question number three, what's his favorite food?
That would be... his traditional food, which is called yam porridge.
Yes. I was worried you wouldn't say it because, you know, you only have 10 seconds. Okay. Focus. You still have 2 more questions to go.
Okay.
Question number 4. What does he like to do in his spare time?
He likes to chill, probably watch The Simpsons, chew on some nuts. Yeah. No?
Yes. He said relax doing nothing or using his computer.
Well, chill.
Yeah,
chill.
Well, no. He didn't mention eating nuts or anything.
Okay.
Well, I'm
right.
Sure he does like to nibble. But all right, I'll let my producer decide on this one. Question number 5. What does he like to, you know, what does he like the most about you, Adama? 10 seconds.
Oh, gosh. Oh, know. What does he like the most about me?
Yes.
Is that I'm like his best friend?
Maybe, but he didn't say that. Okay.
What does he like the most about me? Oh my gosh, my mind has gone so
You're running out of time, Madama.
Oh, what does he like the most about me, my eyes?
Yeah, you're running out of time. No. I'm sure he loves your eyes and everything else, but he said you were the person with the biggest heart.
Oh, yes, of course.
You were very giving. I knew that. Yes.
Yeah.
So, oh. I'm sorry. Well, now okay. It's Sylvester's turn. Are you ready, Sylvester? How confident are you feeling?
She's got three so far, so I think I can beat that, hopefully.
Yeah, so yes. Let's see it. Okay. Question number one, what makes Adama happy?
Oh, food.
Exactly.
Yeah. Food makes her
that was
happy.
Easy. Question number two, what's her favorite lipstick color?
Oh, dear. Probably not. I don't think she actually has one.
That's correct.
Yeah,
well done. She says she doesn't wear any.
Yeah.
Good for you, Adama. Less chemicals on you. Question number three, what's her favorite accessory?
I would say, maybe her, what do you call that thing?
No, I can see it. Were you pointing at the neck? Nope.
Okay, so earrings.
Yes, but I'm not sure if you got it on time, but that's what she said.
Earrings.
Question number four, we'll check that at the end. Let me see if it's still okay, the earrings answer. Question number four, what's her shoe size?
Oh, size 5.
Correctly, yes. Well done. We went easy on you, you know, but you know, I need to start making it a bit harder for you guys. Last question, what does she like the most about you?
I think 10 seconds. Just my calm nature?
Nope.
Okay.
Perhaps, but she didn't say that.
I'm tall, I'm joking, not that one.
Ooh, 10 seconds, just all the wonderful things about yourself.
I'm funny. No.
Yeah, you ran out of time, okay? Everyone
knows
that. She says you are also very, very giving and she loves that about you. It's something that really, you know, attracted her, you know, to you. You're very giving. So well done to you both anyway. Actually, Sylvester, you did a lot better than Adama today, huh?
Thank you very much.
Yeah, we should have you again, you know, back in maybe 10 years' time and see what happens.
Yes. Yeah.
I'll get 100% out of that.
And the score is 3-2 Sylvester, well done. And 2.5, you see how good we've been to you, Adama.
Yeah, you have been.
And you did really well, you know, considering that you've only been married for a month. Okay, but for those at home, let's now find out what are the three most annoying things about each other.
He has this habit of when he's eaten, like 5 minutes after he's had his food, he'll still like make these mushy noises, like, and he'll, you know, lick inside his mouth, and it's just, oh, it's so irritating because it just goes on for ages after he's finished to eat.
Her eating habits, she chews quite audibly, so you could actually hear her go.
When we are asleep, he has a really bad habit of always pulling the duvet. Like, I always wake up with like no duvet on me because he's always got it, you know, clinging onto it, wrapped around it, which is really annoying.
This, she might not like me for this, but she burps worse than a man. So when she's enjoyed something, she just goes burp. It just opens just like that, yeah.
He takes so long to get to the point. Whenever he wants to tell me something, when we're having a conversation, he will tell me about everything else except for what he's trying to get to. So that's really annoying. So usually I have to say, Sylvester, just get to the point.
And the third one, we're still working on. She, I like taking photos, but I don't like to share the photos with everyone. So she likes posting everything, almost everything that we put on.
This program is brought to you by UCKG. This program is brought to you by UCKG.
Welcome back, everyone. Here are our wonderful guests, fresh out of the marriage, the wedding oven. Yeah. How are you guys?
Yeah, we're good, thank you.
So, thank you for married coming. For 1 month?
Yeah, 1 month, yeah.
Wow.
I know, it's gone so quick, isn't it? All the worries about the wedding and all the months prior to the day, you see?
I'm so happy it's all over. It's just back to normal, you know, back to reality. You know?
Well, back to normal, well, but not so normal, because it's a new life now, right? Yeah, you're sharing your house with someone else. So the scores, three
for Sylvester and two and a half.
For Adam. We have to work out how the heck this 2.5 works, because when did we start attributing half points?
It was just, you know, like,
it happened today.
She said half of the question was correct, but not all of it. Mm. So why not? We changed the rules just for you.
I should have been given the half point too for my attempt.
So 3.5.
No, you went over the time. So. Yeah.
Well, we still want that little bit more. So
guys, We're talking today about why people are getting married later. You are changing that trend a little bit, or you broke that trend a little bit with your story, because you got married, by today's standards, you're 25, Adam. So by today's standards, that's relatively young.
Yes.
Why was it getting married young important to both of you?
To be honest, for me, I've always wanted to get married at a young age, even younger, if I could have, if I found him before, like earlier. But I grew up in a household where there was a lot of violence between my parents, and I didn't really see a good marriage between my parents. Okay. So, like, from watching movies and TV programs, you know, how they always make it seem so sweet
happily
and loving
after.
And happily ever after. I love Disney, you know. So I always wanted that. You know, I said, oh, when I have my first boyfriend, I want to marry him and we have children and, you know, that whole big dream. So for me, the sooner, the better, because I didn't want to, I know that once I get married, I wanted a bit of time as well with my husband before we had children.
Right.
So I didn't want to leave it too late.
But
so
it's interesting, because she was saying that, you know, because of the bad environment she had at home growing up.
She still wanted to get married.
Usually most people would have said, no, I don't want to get married because I don't want to go through
it
that.
It has the opposite effect. Yeah. That's interesting.
Yeah, for me it was, I want...
What did you think marriage was going to be, you know, when you were...
What did I think it was going to be like? Well, like I said, because I used to watch a lot of Disney movies, I thought it was, you know, just me and him, we love each other, and, you know, no problems, no worries. Because I remember even when I first started dating Sylvester, I used to say to him, why do people argue in relationships? I don't get it. Like, what do you argue about? Everything should just be fine all the time. If you love each other, then what's the problem?
But then did the arguments come
up? Then, shortly after, I realized.
After we've heard the three most annoying things, then we were like, they were actually very funny. But anyway.
Now, Sylvester, you guys actually knew each other for a while before you even considered dating or even thought about liking each other. Why did it take so long?
Well, should I say opposite to what she said earlier in terms of having a family that was kind of backwards in terms of relationships. I came from one that was like that. My dad has, like, at this time on his seventh wife. So
seventh wife?
Yes, basically on his seventh wife. And, well, of what we know about. Anyway.
There may be more,
but what we know about is like the seventh one. And apart from that, my brother and my sisters, none of them really had like such great
relationships.
And apart from that, I've actually also been part of you know, people who are not sincere in relationships.
Right.
So that completely just threw me off. So
you were the opposite.
I was the opposite of wanting to get married. I just thought, you know, and I love having peace. I don't like to cause trouble.
No confrontations, nothing.
I love peace so much. If you want it, just take it. I just leave it alone.
I'm very much like
I just
do whatever you want.
Just take it, just leave me alone. And I can't give up that freedom of my peace for anyone, or get married and then end up in a brutal marriage or something that I'm not enjoying. So mine was quite different. But then, moving forward, meeting Adam, it did take a while.
How long did it take you?
Well, say we met in 2008, and we are in 2015. Well,
but when did you say, I like this girl? Let me go and tell her that I like her. See what happens.
Okay. Well, it happened almost like A month? Like a month after I met her.
Didn't.
No, you remember what I told you.
We're going to have an argument.
No.
Hold on a second.
Yes.
You don't know how he felt in his heart. You know,
okay.
Inside. He's revealing things to you here now.
How long did it take, Eleanor?
I'd say maybe 8 months.
Okay.
Yeah, so it took a while.
Maybe that 1 month and the next 7 months it was there in your head thinking.
Because I did tell her. Eventually that I ruled out myself in terms of approaching her because I just thought she was out of my league.
Really?
Because of the kind of person that she was. Just really open, down to earth, and just really beautiful as well. So it was something that I just said, I don't think
she... So you thought she was too good for you?
Basically.
Yeah.
Remember, someone...
No, you were perfect for each other.
Remember someone told... I don't know if I told this story here before, but someone told me one day that... when I started dating Elena, someone said, look, I thought
revelations?
When you started
this
dating...
This is a time for revealing things? What was it?
The person said, I thought when you started dating Elena that she was a little bit out of your league.
Why? That's very, very mean comment.
It's not mean. It's just, I think, actually, let me tell
There's
you.
There's things that you think and you don't say.
I took that as a compliment. I said, really? That's great. So that means I punched
the ball. Right, basically.
You see how things are funny? I used to think he's... You know, way out of my league. Just like you thought, yeah, I mean, I got myself a good catch here. You know what I mean? So it's true. So can you see how?
Yeah, it's true.
So what we wanted to find out is this. I mean, you guys, like we said earlier, you are breaking the trend because a lot of people are marrying later, a lot later in life, sometimes because of career commitments because they want to get their career on track first. Others because they want to experience everything the world has to offer and travel and so on. But what was it so different about you? I mean, you mentioned that you growing up, you always wanted that. You didn't, but then you met her. So you thought this is the person. But I mean, were you told by family and friends that you're getting married too young? Were you ever told that?
Yeah, my parents did think that I was a bit too young to get married because... coming from an African home, you know, they usually like it, you know, after you finish university, you get a job and then you get a house and you have to get all these things
and
first.
And then you are 60 years
and old. And you're 60 years old.
Nothing against 60 years old, please.
And then you get married. So,
you know what I mean?
Yeah, that was a bit of a challenge initially, but I just had to let them know that I can still do these things. I can still buy a home together with Sylvester. I can still travel with him.
So much more fun, isn't
it? Exactly. And I get to do it with my best friend. So for me, I understand how people say, oh, you know, when you get married, sometimes they say, oh, you get tied down. But I think it depends on who you marry. But it shouldn't really be the case.
Of course not.
Not at all. So for me, I don't quite understand why people say that. But
Do you think, Elena, that it could be that because there is this pressure now of people having the house, having the car, having the career.
And then living inside the house alone. Yes, I know.
But do you think there is more pressure now from family even for people not to get married as young as before?
I don't think it's the family. Yeah, I think it's become something within themselves. Like, it's like a competition. I don't know about men, but women, they tend to compete a lot against each other. Yeah. I don't know if you notice that.
Yeah, we do.
Who dresses nice. Oh, she already has a career. She already has a house. I've got to do that as well. Oh, my God, everyone has children. I need to get a child, have a child, and this and that, no matter what. So I think it's becoming more. I think some years ago it was family. But now people are very much like, you know, I want to make things happen for myself and then...
Sure. Did you feel that you were like going against the tide, as it were, against the what everyone believes that you should be doing when you got married?
Yeah. I'd say for mine, I had a meeting once in my house where I had a few of my uncles come round, and in his exact words, he said, "Why don't you sample what is out there first?"
Oh, interesting.
Before you get married. And I don't blame him because he's...
I would have understood if your dad told you that. he's been sampling for a while.
For a while, yeah. He still is at such an old age.
Still sampling.
But I thought to myself, I had to first of all look at who was telling me what they were saying, and then I made my judgments from there.
But I want to ask him something, if you don't mind. Okay, you've had, you know, the past that you've had, and then you always wanted to get married. But many people don't get married nowadays because they are afraid of marriage. Like you were a little bit, you know, like, I'm not sure, you know, I haven't had many good experiences. How did you overcome that? How did you change your mind? Because many people are watching us now and they still don't like the idea of marriage. Mm.
It's very true. And apart from the fact of just finding the right person, first of all, you need to give a chance to yourself first to actually know what's out there. Because sometimes people are just, should I say, they only know a certain amount of information, so they don't know what else is out there.
Right.
And I think I gave myself an opportunity to actually find out more, because the kind of people that I was associating with, they led to an unhappy kind of marriage, an unhappy life. But when I learned about a different kind of person, which was Adama,
And it's like you said, that you saw that the people who were telling you, oh, go out and sample what's out there, they didn't really have very good examples for you to follow. So you just said, let me follow my own idea of what's best for me, right?
Yes.
And also, even I think what perhaps helped to change your mind is that you saw in Adama someone that was so special that you were willing to put to one side all the preconceived ideas you had about marriage and just say, let me pounce and grab this one before basically, she gets away, right?
Basically, because... when again for
He's
me it depends it just depends when you look out there, you see a lot of people, they put on this facade, and for her there was no facade. She was literally this is who I am, and I know most people say, oh, later on you get to know the real person, and then even this is who I am kind of changes, but for her, even living together as for a whole month, it's just the burping and the
Let me explain.
Those are the things that has just been very...
It's one of the annoying things.
The annoying things.
Okay. Remember,
well,
the annoying things.
The thing is, once you get married, everything is
everything
out there.
Everything comes out. So.
Okay, we're going to have to take a break, guys.
Okay.
You're a great guest. We want to hear more from you.
Yeah.
But before we go for the break, here's the 60 seconds of this week.
Hello. I believe it's that time again. Welcome to the 60-second hottest celebrity couples. That one from the Arctic Monkeys, Alex Turner, has a new girl with bright colours in her hair. The model Taylor Bagley from New York now appears to be Alex's new arm candy. Kind of looks like candy too. I wonder. Vampire Diaries star Nina Dobrev has been rumoured to be seeing Whiplash star 30-year-old Austin Stowell. The two were getting cosy in the best way possible, through laughter as they were spotted at a comedy show. That's it. She's mastered it. The best way to a man's heart. Pitch Perfect star Rebel Wilson and comedian Mickey Gooch Jr. have made their relationship official. It was reportedly said by The Insider, they get along really well and they respect each other's work. I can only imagine what a phone conversation between the two of them must be like. That's all for now. Bye until next time.
This program is brought to you by UCKG. This program is brought to you by UCKG.
Welcome back. So we have found out about this couple that in 1 month they've been together, everything is out in the open. There's no, it's nowhere to hide, right?
Nope.
Put it all out there.
It's all there on the table or in the air.
Okay, guys, what I wanted you to talk about a little bit is, I mean, there are a lot of people there who have this new idea. I remember my parents who got married when they were really young. I mean, my dad was, I think, 18. My mom was 18, same thing. My grandparents as well. So a few years ago, people were getting married really a lot, you know, very young.
Yes.
Now, maybe we understand, maybe that's a little bit too young, but what are the benefits of getting married young, relatively young, and making that decision early? What are the benefits in that?
I think the benefits, like I sort of mentioned earlier, is that when you start something with someone at a young age, you build your lives together. So you build, I'm going to build my career, he's going to build his, we get a home together, and you know, you kind of move up in life. Because I think the problem is when people tend to get married later, once they've, you know, they've got a good career, they've got a good house, especially with women, and they become very independent. When they do get into marriage, it's usually quite hard for them to cohabit, to adapt to that change, because they've lived most of their lives on their own, doing things on their own. So when they get into that marriage situation, it's a lot more difficult
to share space and let someone in.
Something I wanted to ask you, Adam, and this is one of the complaints that most people who talk about getting married young, this is one of their main complaints. They say, well, I'm 25, I'm going to get married, and that means I'll be waking up next to the same person for the rest of my life. Come on, what if I want to have someone else? Don't you get bored of waking up with the same person every day? What do you have to say to people like that?
I just say, well, just find, that's why you need to make sure you find the right person. Because when you have a best friend, they're usually for life. So for me, Sylvester's my best friend. Why would you want to wake up every morning to your best friend, you know? Mm-hmm. So I think once you find the right person, then you're not going to have that issue of, oh.
It's not an issue.
I think that people who say that are people who haven't found love yet.
Yeah.
Because when you do, you just know. For example, we were talking about getting married young. I was 19 when I got married and you were 21. Mm-hmm. We were very young, but, you know, we found one another and that was it. I didn't have any doubts and I did want to wake up next to him every single
day. And after 14 years, trust me, this is the last thing on our mind. Oh, I'm waking up next to the...
No way.
It's the best. That's the whole point. No, look, that's the point of getting married.
It's even hard to get out of bed because like, oh, no, don't go yet. No.
The whole point of getting married, is this, that you're waking up next to the same person. Yeah. So it's not don't see that as a negative thing. That as the best part of it. Right?
But, you know, the person can't help it. You know, when the person, if you're watching this now, if you think that way, you haven't yet found love. When you do, you will understand what we mean.
And I think just on top of that, it's just an added excuse, basically, to not commit. So probably afraid of commitment
and
finding different excuses not to. So they just say, okay, I don't want to look at this person every day.
But it's interesting because you had all these issues about marriage, but once you saw this person that was so special that you knew, I don't know if I'm going to find another person like this, you said, no, I have to, this is my chance, and this person can be the one who's going to complete my life, so you didn't waste time.
No.
You see, but love does these things.
Mm-hmm.
Love changes people, isn't it?
Changes your mind.
So I even wanted to ask you, after you got married and everything, what was the hardest thing for you? I mean, because you're still in honeymoon, isn't it? What am I asking you?
Well, still... it was one of mine for me.
What was the like, oh, wow, I wasn't sure.
It's nothing serious, really. It's just, like I said, with the most annoying thing is that he pulls the covers.
Like, just get yourself an extra one. That's
I'm going to have to, because it's just all the time.
Oh, buy him a sleeping bag, so all compact.
But he's a big guy, he's a tall guy.
He's always hugging the duvet.
But, like, seriously speaking, I personally, because of the person that she is, I wouldn't say I've noticed a massive change. For me, you said honeymoon period. I want to look at it like this. I am continuing my friendship with her on a more permanent basis. That's how I'm looking at it, because she's just been so open and so straightforward that now it's just like...
Okay.
Most things she does doesn't surprise me.
It's so nice to see a couple like...
So guys, it's amazing to hear your story. Inspirational. Yes. I think a lot of young people will look at your story and say, look, I want some of that. I think that's...
Because they are the ones missing out, not those who are married.
I think when... Yeah. And by the way, don't get married young just for the sake of it, right? Yeah. It has to be with the right person. And when we say young, it's not 17 years old. Wait a little bit more, right? But if once you are at a point in your life where you're stable, you're happy, and you found the right person, then that's probably the right time to take that step. Now, Elena and I went on a special date. We went on this tea party, not party, like a tea date.
Wasn't it too girly?
Tea afternoon. No, it was okay. But we did it on a double-decker bus, a very special double-decker bus, doing a tour of London and having a tea afternoon at the same time.
Totally recommend that.
Have a look. We'll be right back. Now, everyone knows that afternoon tea is a favorite English pastime, and we're going to do that just now, but with a twist. because we're going to have afternoon tea aboard a very old-style London bus.
That's right. It's going to be afternoon tea and also sightseeing all in one. And as the slogan of the company says, we are going to experience this, you know, on today's trip for two. As you can tell, we are at the heart of the city and we are going to be sightseeing places like Hyde Park, the London Eye, the Houses of Parliament, of course, Buckingham Palace, and so much
and
more.
And many more.
Yes.
The Bibi Bakery will be providing some exquisite sandwiches and cakes for a little bit of taste of France here in the heart of London.
Uniform driver will be taking us on an hour and a half sightseeing tour, and this is a very popular thing these days, and you can even hire these kind of buses for weddings, hen parties, birthdays, and also corporate events.
Now the bus driver is uniformed. The sunglasses are not part of the uniform, but they're really cool. I hope you get a chance to see them. And of course, this is not something great only for dates, but also to catch up with some friends.
Yes.
Let's get on the bus.
Let's go.
Guys, my name is John Philippe. This is my friend Alice.
Hello.
You will see my dark colleague. She's called Emmeline. Our only mission on board is to please you.
I'll have peppermint. Frank, this is a camera.
I'm not a big fan of too much chocolate.
It's good.
It's bad for my diet.
It's a good macaroon.
Yummy. It's a quiche.
Very good.
Yeah, I think it looks more civilized.
Yeah, it does. Alright.
Fine. So I was telling our cameraman, who just arrived here in England a couple of months ago, that he has to try a few
things
that are special about the British culture. One of them, couldn't be more British, is the scones with clotted cream. And the thing is,
and jam, but he only has cream.
Listen, the thing is, you can't put a little bit. If you're going to put on weight, you might as well go all out. Just put as much as you can, and then just go for it. And that's it. Let's see.
You forgot the jam.
No jam. If you, jam spoils everything.
What if you have half?
No. This is how
okay,
I like
then.
By the way, you see, this is how sometimes your other half is trying to persuade you to do something you don't want to do.
Because I can see this going wrong, but let's see.
No, it's not going to go wrong. It's perfect.
Ah, okay. It's going quite well.
Yeah. Perfect. Now, the cameraman will stop filming and he'll try for himself. More or less saw there, because they are now doing some maintenance work, is where Elena and I had one of our first, very first dates.
Indeed, our first picture together.
Mm-hmm. Elena looks
there.
a little bit cold. She had, remember, you had
I had a big coat on.
Big coat
actually,
on.
I still have that picture, you know?
Maybe we can use it in the show. You can see it right now. Our producer just put it there.
Oh, and, so many good memories, isn't it? My first time here in London.
So we just finished our tour. We had a really wonderful time.
Very
ate some really good food. And in the end, you get to take away your, you know, whatever you didn't eat in these wonderful little bags.
Yes.
It's pink. My producer has forced me to hold one of these. But it's okay because I'm confident with my masculinity. So it's fine. Don't worry.
I know you are. Very, very nice tea. Very good quality cupcakes and sandwiches and everything. Mm-hmm. I was impressed.
That's it.
Definitely recommend.
We had a wonderful time and join us next time for our next trip for two.
Bye.
I hope you enjoyed that as much as we did.
Oh, it was wonderful.
And it's really amazing to have this really nice afternoon tea while seeing the landmarks in London.
And the staff, they are just really so friendly.
And attentive.
Yeah,
as well.
And funny, very entertaining.
Mm-hmm. Now, perhaps one of the most important things to mention here today is that sometimes the things that are now despised and ignored were once the foundations of family, the foundations of what was important in our life. And perhaps one of these things is now marriage. Marriage, unfortunately, has lost its value. Yeah. People seem to put it in the back burner, forget about it completely. And it is one of the most fulfilling and special things you can have.
It's very sad because I can so see in a few years' time as having the family museum, free entry.
The marriage museum.
Free entry. Everyone is welcome to see what those things used to be called family and children and a happy family, but it's actually very sad, but
So our advice is, no one should get married early for the sake of marrying early, but certainly make this something that is a goal for you, to establish a family, a happy family, a loving family. And sure, many people will say, I can establish a family without being married. Well, that's up for debate. But that special bond of saying to that person, I will be with you for the rest of my life and build a life with you for the rest of my life. That is something key that needs to be cultivated and embraced more even in today's culture. Don't forget, you can get in touch, send us your questions to questions@lovetalkshow.tv. And if you want to be a guest on our show, perhaps you have an amazing story to tell, you can also email us in and ask to be here on the show. It'll be a pleasure to have you. Of course, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. We hope you've enjoyed today's program. Until next time, bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Well, that's all for today's show. Don't forget to tune in next time for another topic on The Love Talk Show.
How love, tearing me apart.
This program is brought to you by UCKG.